Public meeting is happening tonight over the fate of the John B. Castleman statue in the Highlands. This follows the city's removal of the George Prentice statue last month.
George Prentice now sits in storage. A final spot for Castleman has been tougher to agree upon, though. This morning, we're asking you, should the John B. Castleman monument be moved? Many of you voted throughout the night. We're going to continue to vote throughout the morning on WHAS11.com/vote. And right now, 90% say it should stay where it is. Again, we're going to continue to vote. For now, we want to check in with Rob Harris. He's been talking with a historian to get a clearer picture of this Castleman history. Is it more complex than most people figure out from the start when they start talking about these statue controversies?
Definitely. So Castleman gets thrown in with a lot of other Confederate statues in this debate, but it's actually a little trickier than that. First of all, the statue at Cherokee Triangle isn't technically a Confederate statue. He's not wearing Confederate garb in the depiction. Also, Castleman's time as a Confederate soldier is only part of his story. Now, to be clear, he did fight for the Confederacy. In fact, he was part of a group called the Morgan's Raiders. They were a Confederate unit that became pretty notorious for raiding Union towns and farms and prisons. At one point, he was actually arrested and sentenced to death. However, his sentence ended up being commuted, so he lived. And after the war, his life got a little bit tamer. He became a Louisville businessman. Later, he would serve for the Union Army as a military officer. He's one of the fathers of the Louisville Park system, too. And contrary to some legends surrounding him, the parks actually were not fully segregated until years after he died. Here's the thing, though. Even though he learned to get along with his Union neighbors, he never renounced his time as a Confederate. In fact, at the end of his life, he was still pretty proud of all the things he did with the Morgan's Raiders. So that's why local historian Tom Owen, who sat on the advisory committee deliberating the statue, says he ultimately agreed that it should be moved.
He is a mixed bag. Was he repentant from his service of the Confederacy? Absolutely not. Did he have a distinguished career that worked both sides of the, was he part of that white adjustment or agreement among whites to try to put the Civil War behind us? Yeah, he was very much a part of that. But as the mayor says, there's no public statue that should be located in any place in Louisville that cannot be located comfortably in every place in Louisville.
Now, since Dr. Owen is a local historian, it's very important to him that history is recorded and remembered. So I asked him if he has the same fears that some people do, that if we get rid of statues like this, we'll forget our past and lose the connection to roots. He said that he's very confident that John Castleman will always be remembered here in Louisville, particularly because of his work in the park system. But we've been asking you on social media what you think, what your opinion is on what the statue should happen. We have Wilma saying, leave it where it is. A statue doesn't hurt anyone. It doesn't bother you. If it bothers you, don't look at it. The next one we have is Linda. She says, remove the man, leave the beautiful horse. After that, we have Mary Jo. She says, I think it's ridiculous that we're trying to erase history. We all have history, good or bad, so we're going to be erased or moved. And we have Richard. He says, move it. But when we're looking at the vote today, 90% of you right now are saying no, you do not think it should be removed. But keep your votes coming in, and we will be checking in with this one last time at the end of the newscast.